this lovely lady used to come to Cape Town and MC all these amazing events, and I loved her energy. So ladies and gents, please put your hands together for Hulisani Ravele.
The first choice that I've made in my life is really to just know myself and to own my story. I grew up in this industry and the name was Sisi Ravele. And the question then becomes, so why the name change? The reason I use the name Sisi is because it's short for Cecilia, firstly, for those that don't remember. And the reason I was called Cecilia is because when I went and joined an agency at age 9, the casting director didn't know how to say my name, Hulisani. So they're just like, ah, it's Cecilia Ravele. So when I made the choice, Yahuri, actually, you're going to call me by my name, my African name, and you're going to learn how to say it. When I ask myself the question, how have you managed to stay in this game and not lose your way? It is because I have a strong understanding of who I am and where it is I come from. And because these people in this picture, this is just my mom's side of the family. Never treated me differently because I was on television. I owe my being, I owe my success to who these people have made me to be today, and I'm forever grateful. I will never lose who Hulisani Ravele is because they never forget who Hulisani Ravele is. Even the day I arrived to accept my Emmy Award for the Best International Talk Show, I will never forget that I am this person. To me, a sustainable brand is a brand that people will ask for long after it's gone. You want to arrive now and make it happen now, but it honestly takes time. It's about longevity. It's about being in the game for the right reasons, and it's about outliving those that will come and go. Some of you are too busy looking on the sides that you're missing the miracle that you see in the mirror every single morning. Every single day, because you're comparing yourself to other people. I call it keeping up with the Kumalos instead of keeping up with the Kardashians. Lippy easily shevile next door. Run your own race and you will see just how much further and faster you will go. Without patience, without perseverance, and without prayer, I honestly would not be the girl that I am today. June has been the most incredible month for me. Not only is it Youth Month, not only was it an opportunity to come and share here today, but after 21 years in the game, I got my first magazine cover. Because I am so clear and so focused and so dedicated to what I know I believe and stand in, I know that every single time I'm given an opportunity, I'm going to knock it out the park. The most important thing about rebranding or branding under general is just always being staying true to yourself, because where I believe we lose it is when you're trying to be something that you're not, and therefore you forget sometimes because you're like, oh, am I on? Am I off? So when you're just always authentically yourself, there's nothing easier than just waking up and doing you and being you. So I think authenticity will always win at the end of the day. In order for my brand and my career to last, it's okay for me to be into different things. We're a slasher generation because you're a photographer slash presenter slash businesswoman slash, and I say that's okay. That's the generation we are because the times allow us to be that. And that's something I really want to impart on you, that to register your business is what, less than $300? But imagine the opportunity that you could possibly walk away from and lose because they don't have time for you to be getting ready. Trusting yourself as a young person to be able to do great things. You want to hold on to your concept so badly and hold on to your business so badly all by yourself that when it's generating nothing, it's nothing. When you are so obsessed and so focused on holding on to this thing because it's your dream and nobody else can do it, then sometimes you're just going to go to that graveyard with your dream. But it's not about how I start and how I stumble. It's about whether I make the choice to stand up again. But I've become a freelancer that runs herself as a business, which means that I invoice for everything from my business and I pay myself a set salary. Why? Because today you're going to make 10 rand. Tomorrow you might make 0 rands. And life is patient, guys. It will teach you the same lesson over and over and over again. When are you going to start listening? Living better is understanding that it's a series of choices. It's getting to a T-junction. You're like, am I going to go this way? Am I going to go that way? And whatever way you decide to go, to be okay with that. I live better because I know that all things are working together for my good. And that's the question I leave you with today. If you are truly going to be intentional about living better, who are you to not root for yourself? In all things, I really just wish you discover your purpose, harness his power, and watch the impact. Noriwanga Mami.